Liverpool er ute av Champions League, og nå blir det fullt fokus på å sikre kvalifisering til neste års Champions League. Velkommen til pausepraten torsdag 15. april ved Arve Vassbotten. Det blir ikke noe nytt comeback fra Liverpool i Champions League denne sesongen. Liverpool er nå ute av turneringen etter 0-0 mot Real Madrid på onsdag, og dermed ble 3-1-tapet i Madrid avgjørende. Klopp var likevel godt fornøyd med det Liverpool viste frem på Anfield, men effektiviteten ble ødeleggende denne gangen.
We started the game extremely well and could have obviously scored there early, but we didn't. We were good in the game, we played much better, we didn't lose the tie tonight, we lost the game obviously in Madrid, that's clear, with the performance we put there out, which was not good enough. Today it was good enough to go 1-0 up for sure, and then it would have been a different game. But so with the experience of Real Madrid and the situation, like you have to chase a game, that you have to score and stuff like this, it got more and more difficult, obviously. And so they controlled the game from a specific moment on, had then their counter-attacking chances themselves. But obviously, what we saw tonight, we could have, with two good performances, we would have had a better chance to go through. One good performance without scoring, then anyway, was on enough.
På Liverpool.no's spillebørs etter kampen ble Trent Alexander-Arnold kåret til hjemmelagets bestemann og fikk 8 på børsen. Aktiv offensivt og med langt færre problemer defensivt enn i Madrid. Mange gode passninger og innlegg, og ikke minst var han angrepslinken de siste 45 minuttene. Alt i alt en god kamp, og Liverpools beste etter vår mening, heter det i begrunnelsen. Best ut på folkebørsen, der leserne selv stemmer frem sin bestemann, er Alisson Becker, som fikk 7,5 i snitt. Klopp vil nå fokusere fullt og helt på Premier League og bruke de ekstra treningene for å sikre deltakelse i neste års Champions League med 7 kamper igjen. Første utfordring er mot et fysisk tøft Leeds-lag på mandag.
But it has now no impact on the Premier League apart from that we don't play midweeks, at least international anymore. I'm pretty sure Premier League plays midweeks if I'm right. So we can concentrate and focus on the Premier League what we will and what we have to. But it's tough. Just we are still not in the hot seat, I would say, and we faced Leeds on Monday, so that's a tough one. What can I say? That they are leader in all physical stats in the Premier League, pretty much. So you better run a lot yourself. And we have a few days until then. We will use that, and then we make sure that we are ready for that. We are not in a bad moment in the moment. We played pretty well, even when it was a late winner against Aston Villa, but we played a good game against them. We played really good against Arsenal. So not so good against Real Madrid, the first leg, but the other games were not bad. Tonight, a good game, so we just have to keep going. We really have to keep going. We have to keep fighting, and we want to be next year in the Champions League. But in a moment, as I said, we still have to pick up more points than a lot of other teams.
Det er 56 år siden bortemålsregelen ble innført i fotball, med begrunnelsen om at bortekamper var tøft, og at det enkleste var å legge seg bakpå og mure igjen. UEFA kommer trolig ikke til å fjerne bortemålsregelen helt, men fra neste sesong vil det ikke lenger være tellende i ekstraomganger, melder The Telegraph. For 32 år siden reiste tusenvis av Liverpool-supportere til Sheffield for å se semifinalen i FA-cupen mellom Liverpool og Nottingham Forest 15. april 1989. 96 mennesker kom aldri tilbake fra Hillsborough. Det skal vi aldri glemme. Vi avslutter denne podcasten med 1 minutt stillhet for de 96. Du har akkurat lyttet til pausepraten det siste døgnet med Liverpool fra Liverpool Supporterklubb Norge. En nyhetssending som legges ut på alle hverdager. For flere nyheter, besøk liverpool.no.